We're checking in here post-fight tonight. The Brooklyn Masonic Temple on the other side of another knockout and win number 10 for the man of the hour, Scotty Bang Bang Burrell, who is also being flanked by his twin brother Dean and also trainer Don Saxby. But Scotty, I'm going to throw it on you first. Clearly you came out there feeling good tonight, but walk me through that quick first round, this quick night of work.
First round, the guy came out quite lively. I was lively myself. I was a little bit over anxious in the first round. I kind of jumped on him a little bit too much. I told myself to just cool down a little bit. The guy was making mistakes, but I was being a little bit too overzealous. I come back to the corner, done cold, relaxed a little bit more. Picked up on some mistakes he was making. Fake to the body, come out the left foot. So the second round, I come out a little bit more relaxed and straight away, round the money. From then, I just get the pressure. I knew I could hurt him. I hurt him again. I just said, I had him really back into the rope, so I just stayed on him.
Finished off the job. And now, Don, from your perspective over in the corner, clearly you had to be happy with this performance, but go ahead and take me through it from your perspective, what you saw out there tonight from Scotty.
Well, first of all, I thank God for the victory. I noticed that he was a little overzealous also. But the first thing I told him when he went out, just said, don't pay any attention to this crowd. You're going to have everybody yelling, do this, jump on him. Take your time. I told him, I didn't care if he won the first round or lost the first round. I just wanted to feel the guy out and see what he was going to try first. And lo and behold, he didn't come out like we thought he was going to come out. But he was making mistakes, and it was like a habit. He kept doing this with a habit. When Muscati would jab to the body, he would do this. I said, the first thing came to mind, I got him. I got him because he keeps doing it. He's got to come on the top. I'm going to make Scotty go out there. Listen, calm down first. So go out there, take a step, then fade to the body, come on top of the hole. You're going to land it. You're fast. You're going to land it. Get out there. That's what started the knockout. And I'm really, really pleased with his performance. I really liked him to go to the body a little more, but he had him hurt because we worked on a particular combination when we get a guy against the ropes. But overall, I'm really, really pleased with what he's done. He worked hard. He earned it. He was in shape. I want to thank Deion Teller. I want to thank Elmo Serrano, boy Joel Guzman, and everybody that supported him and everybody that was in his corner. I want to thank your brother Dean, Slick Mick, for that last session, his beginning session, his last session. So we were well prepared. It's a 10-round fight. We were well prepared. And if he didn't go out there in that second round, I knew I had a plan for that third round. I said, I'm going to get him out in the third round if I'm going to get him in the second. But hey, he got the job.
I'm going to wait in the second round and figure him out.
Yeah. I knew we were going to get him. And we made him move more than because he came out different, like I said, because when we watched him, he normally comes forward. But this time, he was moving around, which I was kind of glad too. Because I was disturbing, I was going to make Scotty go after him a little bit more and make him use his legs more than he wanted to. Once he got a little tired, he's going to get him standing still, then we could bang on him a little bit more. That's why we call him Bang Bang.
Bang Bang.
Bang Bang Gang was in the house. He bust his guns.
Just like that, Bang Bang, it was over.
Proud of him. It's my debut as his head coach. I got me a second round knockout.
There you go. And now, Dean, there's no other man that understands what your brother goes through more than you have, obviously. Y'all put all this work in together. And, I'm gonna flip it on you now. Last time when, you picked up the W out here, I asked your brother this question. Now I'm going to throw it to you. It's got to be, it's always difficult to see somebody's just your friends out there fighting. Very difficult to see somebody's your relative. Your brother, obviously, even more serious. But when that's your twin brother, your other half out there, talk me, through the fighting as, the emotions you feel as he fights out there.
I wasn't really that nervous because I know he's very well prepared. You know what I'm saying? So, obviously, it's a fight, so you've got to be on the A game. But I wasn't really that nervous because I know he's well prepared. After the first round started, I saw that the guy was making some mistakes, but I also saw the guy was a little more lively than some of the videos. I trusted Don, I trusted Cat in the corner that he's going to pick up the mistakes that the guy's making and correct some of the stuff that's got to be doing. So I was a bit nervous, but I knew he had it under control. Of course, second round he came out, he was in control. control from the beginning, pulled the guy with some good punches. And I knew that, you know, like, the guy's not moving his head too much, so, you know, if you hit him once, you're going to hit him again. So, yeah.
Right, right.
I clipped him early in the second round, and I would have, you know, I got him later on again.
He was about to go, and that's when Scotty went ahead and closed it out. But Scotty, when we talked earlier this week, something we brought up is double-digit wins. You know, that's a big landmark for a fighter. You know, a lot of fighters obviously never get there. You know, talk to me a little bit about 10 wins and how good it feels to look at your record now and you see double digits.
Good, man. I sent to you in the previous interview that, you know, I love to get my 10th win with a knockout. And, you know, it came back out. I went to the conference. And, yeah, I've been in the ring for maybe 5-6 months. So I wanted to come in and lose my first fight with Don and Cap. So I wanted to come in there and, you know, make a statement. And I feel like I did that. Like I said, I had a great training camp. Don worked me hard, Cat worked me hard, Drum Guzman worked me hard. So, you know, I've learned a lot of new things. So I come in and remember a lot of different things in my head. I've been practicing some new stuff in the gym. So, you know, we're still molding everything together. But, you know, feel good to go out there.
Absolutely. And Don, going back to what you were saying, you know, this being the first fight with Scotty in there as the head trainer. Talk to me a little bit about the team and everything and how everything's been going with that training since you started working with both of these two with these two gentlemen.
It's great training both of them because, we, you know, like I said, we have Joanne Guzman, who's one of the slickest fighters who I actually used to train. He knows boxing. You know, I can't train with not no boxing because I'm going to pick that up right away. No, listen, he's a good team. He's learning new things. He already knows how to fight. You know, one thing I'm gonna take, they know boxing. We're just adding and tweaking whatever they, you know, little deficiencies I'm looking for, tweaking it. They don't get a moment's rest. Anytime they make a mistake, we call them on it. No, don't do that. Don't do that. Don't do that. We don't like that. No, don't make that move. You'll get countered. Make this move. Step this way. Step around that way. We're giving them so many different weapons. We're adding to what they already know how to do. And we take advantage of the fact that they both are very, very fast. As you notice, when he faked that jab to the body, that guy didn't even see that left hook. He didn't even see it. Not seeing it. Once he heard it, this fight's over. If it ain't over, that third round was going to be over. But like I said, then we're giving them more weapons. You know, they have, and it's funny that he said it. He's learned so many different things. Had the rounds went on, you would have seen a whole lot of other things that he's had to do.
Coming to the second round, so I relaxed.
Yeah.
Some more tricks coming out the bag, I see.
Yeah. Old school tricks, new school tricks. We're just giving them more weapons. I mean, these guys are going to be champ. I don't care what anybody says. These guys are going to be champions. I don't care. I'm just that confident as a trainer, and I'm confident in their ability. I really am. You know what I mean? So some people will be like, you know, and I say that with all sincerity. Some people say, oh, they look like they'll be. No. They haven't even, listen, 12 fights, 10 fights. To me, they're still beginning moves. They still have about to learn in their body, and they're picking it up. So, you know, sky's the limit. Sky's the limit as far as I'm concerned.
That's it right there.
I'm looking to take I'm looking to take the boxing game in the choke. I'm going to put in the choke with my whole team. And we're going to do it.
There you go. And on this side over here, Don, we're going to stay in your face, documenting the whole thing. But to finish this off here, I'm going to let everybody close it out. Of course, Scott, you're going to take the final sign off. But Dean, any closing comments for the people out there?
I just want to be, you know, I'm just grateful for the one that came to support. You know, of course, I have to give thanks to the Most High, you know, for everything. Thank Don and the coaches and everyone that worked with my brother. You know, on to the next one.
Don, closing remarks.
Soccer continues. You already know.
There it is. Scotty, go ahead and take us home.
Yeah, I'd like to thank God, Victory, thank Don, Cat, Jerome Guzman, my brother, my wife, everyone that's helped me out. You know, it's been a great training camp. You know, great for
everybody. That's a beautiful thing. 10 wins is looking awful nice, especially when you sparked it with with fireworks here tonight, Scotty. But we're going to let y'all get on out of here.
It was the raps. It was the raps. I don't care what it is. It was the raps. And the headband.
There it is. Yeah. But they better start mopping the floors. They're going to mop us up out of here. And I want to make sure y'all get out of here safely tonight. So we'll go ahead and close it out from here. But to all three of you gentlemen, want to thank you very much. Scotty, great win. Of course, your brother and Don, great win as well. And this will go ahead and close out.
Sports for life. We out.
Saga continues.
Saga continues.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at 1:02 of round number 2. Referee Ricky Gonzalez scores a home for the